Now let's move on to special lecture one. The first special lecturer is a well-renowned scholar, and he has full of insights for the future. Mr. Jacques Attali, president of Attali Associates, and he's going to be talking about boosting the economy of life. This is a pre-recorded message. Please enjoy.
Good morning. I'm delighted to be with you. The lessons we can draw from this pandemic are very clear. It is obvious that the world has not been in a situation to provide enough efficient forecast for the situation of the world in due time. It was true for many catastrophes. It was true for climate change. It was true for the pandemics. It was true, and it is true also for the growth of the inequalities and many other problems that are facing the world, such as the growth of public debts, the potential threat of inflations, and many other problems. But the demonstration was that the world needs to make more efforts to forecast in the future and to prepare for the danger that are coming out of these dangers and to provide solutions. As far as the pandemic is concerned, it is clear that the pandemic is really the occasion to realize that there are many, many sectors that are not enough developed and many sectors which are overdeveloped. The sectors that are overdeveloped are the sector linked to what I call the economy of death, which are sectors that create problems for climate, such as everything which is linked to fossil fuels, not only the fossil fuels industry itself, coal, gas, and oil, but also everything which is produced with gas, oil, and fossil fuels in general, such as some production of electricity, plastics, chemistry, textiles, cars, planes, boats, which use the mobility based on fossil fuels. Packaging, which is linked to fossil fuels, the fashion industry, which is linked to plastic as a tool for producing textiles, many other dimensions, such as tourism, which is linked to the use of fossil fuel, and other sectors which are linked of other element of economy of death, such as everything which is linked to sugar, artificial sugar, and therefore bad agriculture, bad food, many things which are related to other kind of poisons, such as drugs. And I would add also virtual gaming, which when they are used in excess, could be considered as a drug, and is a destruction of the capacity of focusing of children. This is largely part of the economy of death, in which we find not only fossil fuels, artificial sugars, but also a large part of the use of social networks and a large part of existing agriculture. This economy represents more than 60% of the GDP of the main countries, while the other, the economy of life, represent only 40% of the main economies, such as health, education, digitals, hygiene, clean energy, clean water, research, democracy, culture, entertainment, sound finance, sound insurance, renewable and sustainable housing, smart cities, many other fields linked to those. The problem of today and tomorrow is to be in position to switch from economy of death to economy of life, not only through more investments in the sectors of economy of life, but also in the sectors of training people towards the sectors of economy of life. We need more people in the sectors of health, education, clean energy, clean water, good agriculture. We need more knowledge on that. And this should be done not because it is only good, but it is also good for the economy. People believe that health and education and training are a burden on the economy, and that, on the contrary, fossil fuels, car industry, or the other sectors are good for growth. It's not true. Health, education, training are good for the development of the economy, and that they are growth factors. If health grows, and if there is a growth in health spending, and if it is efficiently used to increase the life expectancy, to reduce the difficulties or problem with pain for anyone, this is good for the good quality of life, and therefore it's good for the growth of the economy. The same with education and training. It's clear that the more you have good education, the more you have a more efficient and productive countries, and therefore we need to increase drastically the share of the GDP which is devoted to health, education, hygiene, good food, and this must be done through all dimensions. As I said before, this must be done by training people, by refocusing the investment, by channeling insurance funding, by channeling spendings by governments and taxes and subsidies in those directions. Those sectors must be priorities. This will change not only the content of GDP, but also change the nature of a way of life, because economy of life doesn't mean only to spend more in the sectors of economy of life, but to spend less in the other sectors, and to transform these other sectors in the good directions. That switch is very important. That switch may lead to the fact that we understand that growth is not only a matter of GDP production, but it's also a matter of a better use of time. And better use of time doesn't mean only better use of time by spending things. There are very often a huge amount of time that you can use without spending anything. And that is true for many dimensions. If, for instance, I spend too much money in food and that eat some dirty food every 10 minutes, I destroy my health and I do not produce anything good. Boosting the economy of life doesn't mean only to transform economy of death in economy of life, but also to develop the existing time available for activities which are not activities used to buy, sell, or produce things for the market, but time used to be free, to think, to discuss, to be available for friends, for family, which is absolutely crucial for a sound and sustainable society. If we keep on developing only activities which are linked to the market, if we develop only activities which are to buy and sell, produce, buy and sell, we'll die. It will be economy of death by all means. We need to develop activities which are out of market, free activities, telling stories, making sport, making music, spending time to discuss and think with friends and family. This is not details, this is fundamental. And this is the real transformation of society. We need to understand that the aim of society is not to have a stockpile of products, but to have good time and to prepare the next generation to have better good time and more good time. What means good time means time free for thinking, taking pleasure and joy, creating and transmitting to next generation. The time for that is a very precious time, more important than anything else. And the economy of life must be only a way to organize this transmission and this free moment in life. It is a huge transformation which is needed, transformation in the vision, transformation in the project, transformation in the conduct of the economy, moving one of the sectors of economy of death to the sectors of economy of life, and transforming the relations between individuals in order for them to understand that a good time is more important than having more products or better car. This is a change in ideology, a change in culture, a way to get out of the intoxication of a market economy, intoxication of a consumer goods, and intoxication also of everything which is linked to excess use of drugs, will it be medical drugs or virtual drugs, which are for the moment more than ever dangerous. And boosting economy of life is booting life by all means. This is a challenge which is a condition for survival of mankind.
네, 여러분 다시 한번 큰
Another round of applause, please. Thank you very much for that passionate message. In order to achieve a sustainable future, we need to make sure that we transform to the economy of life. That is how important our consumption of time is. Up until now, we have taken a look at the future direction for investment as well as the consumption of time. Thank you very much.